Hi, my name is Luke Allen, president of OHD.
My name is Booth Armstrong, national sales manager at OHD.
Today, we're going to provide a QuantiFit2 demonstration of this respirator fit testing device utilizing controlled negative pressure technology found within every global regulation around the world.
Yeah, a great way to get started today is to give you a good explanation of controlled negative pressure and how the QuantiFit2 system challenges the fit of a respirator.
And the way that technology works is it pulls a heavy breathing rate or a working rate on the respirator. And once that respirator has that breathing rate pulled, it measures air leakage into the respirator. And that's a key difference of this technology is it utilizes air to challenge the respirator and measure leak to provide a fit factor during fit testing.
Yeah. I've always enjoyed explaining controlled negative pressure to people by letting them know about the two unique capabilities of the QuantiFit2. Its first unique capability is it can evacuate the air out of a respirator, put that respirator under a precise negative pressure, and hold that negative pressure for a short period of time. The second unique capability of the QuantiFit2 system is it can tell you the exact amount of air down to the cc that leaks into that respirator when it's under that negative pressure, giving us the ability to determine the fit and integrity of that respirator at a high level.
Yeah, and the respirators that this technology can test are half mask, elastomeric, all the way up to CBRN, military respirators, SCBA type of respirators, anything in between there. As I mentioned before, the technology is found within every global regulation around the world, ISO, OSHA, HSE, whatever your local regulation is, controlled negative pressure should be found.
Let's jump into the features and benefits of the QuantiFit2. You can list out the features and benefits through four major categories: speed, ease, innovation, and accuracy. I'll get us started with talking about speed. The QuantiFit2 utilizes a testing protocol called the Redyne protocol. It's a five-step test. Each step takes 8 seconds. A fit test can be completed in under 2 minutes. So it's a very fast quantitative respirator fit test. Another thing that really indicates the speed of our testing process is the QuantiFit2 will give you the ability to retest a failed step, which has a dynamic impact on keeping the testing process moving at a high pace.
Yeah, and the next section would be ease, and kind of the transition there would be speed. As it flows into ease would be the speed of setup of the technology. So you can do a full calibration and setup of the instrument under 5 minutes because we're able to do testing in any environment, which is another part of the ease of use of technology. Because we're using air, we're able to test outside, inside, dirty environments, clean environments, anywhere that you want to run your technology, this system can operate, which again allows you to calibrate quicker, get up for testing quicker. The other nice thing is there's no consumables. So there's no alcohol solutions required, no probing, no wicks, none of the different components that you have with other technologies. This system has adapters that we'll show you in just a second, connect straight up to your mask or your respirator and allows you to go through fit testing easily. No probing of the respirator, so you don't have to run the probes into the oral nasal passage or the breathing zone as you do with other technologies. Again, with this, there's quick connect adapters to connect straight up to the respirator for testing. There's no concerns with particles in lungs. That's a big thing with other technologies, qualitative and some quantitative methods. Are you worried about people that have particles in their lungs or things that could cause them to have failures in fit testing? Because we use air as our challenge agent, we're not worried about any of those things. So you can come in, jump straight into fit testing really quickly.
Absolutely. Innovation. First thing we'll start on in innovation is the onboard data capability of the QuantiFit2. Virtually can store unlimited companies, unlimited test subjects, and unlimited test results on the instrument itself. Next thing that I would talk about on innovation is the device can be run off of mainline power or battery power. It's a lithium ion battery. On a complete charge, you can complete somewhere around 80 fit tests with that battery. Next thing we talk about is the user interface that is primarily driven by the color touchscreen. There's infographics, there's animations that support you through the testing process, the fit testing process, and the color touchscreen even allows you to gather a signature of the operator in the test subject if desired. Last two things I would tell you about on innovation is the instrument has interactive troubleshooting. So if you fail a step on the QuantiFit2 test, the QuantiFit2 actually has the ability to support the operator's troubleshooting of why that failure may have occurred. And then the last thing, which I think is really neat about our technology, is the QuantiFit2 comes with a lifetime powertrain warranty. As long as the instrument is calibrated on an annual basis, the main components of the instrument are covered for the life of the equipment, and that's really, really unique with our technology.
Yeah, and the last section would be accuracy. So because we use air as the challenge agent, which we've talked a lot about, controlled negative pressure pulls that challenge pressure on the respirator, and air is the most stringent challenge agent that's out there. So we're not worried about the leak source size or the different particles or the challenge to the respirator. Any air that leaks into the respirator is measured and reported as leak. So again, this is the most accurate technology that's on the market, which is why we want to talk a bit about that. And we can, again, measure direct measurements of leak each time for each step and the overall fit test. So now let's transition into that fit test and show you the unit in action. All right, let's jump into a test with the QuantiFit2 system. There's two ways that you can run the instrument. One is through our Logic software, which is free to download off our website or comes with the instrument. Today, we're gonna show you how to run the system through a standalone version, which is all run through the user interface. And again, Booth mentioned that we have virtually unlimited data storage on the unit, and also testing can be synced back into Logic software, so there's interconnectivity between those two platforms. Another thing that's important to know is that we have adapters for every respirator around the world. So today we're going to show this specific respirator, but whatever respirator that you're using for your protection program, we have adapters for those respirators. So Booth's already been in the mask. What we're going to do is get started with our test now. So once we're ready, step one of the read-on protocol, which Booth mentioned earlier, is a face forward. And when he's ready, he's going to take a breath and hold it. And the machine is going to pull that breathing rate on the respirator. So he took his breath, he's holding his breath. The machine is pulling this working rate that we talked about earlier on the respirator, and it's measuring leak into the respirator now. So if Booth gets a pass as he did, he'll move to step two, and he's gonna go ahead and do that. So again, the key is the employee or the subject is taking a breath and holding it, which is the requirement that they have to do during the test to challenge the respirator through a breathing rate that the machine is pulling. So the machine is virtually like their lungs pulling that working rate as they're doing the different movements. Step three of the read-on protocol is a shaking of the head and a talking out loud. Then he's going to stop and face forward. What we're looking for here is, does the respirator reseat to his face? Very important when you do respirator fit testing, because respirators move during the day. The question is, do they reseat properly to your face? Is it the right size? Is it the right tightness of those straps? The last two steps of our protocol are super unique to controlled negative pressure. We're the only system in the world that uses the read-on protocol. This challenges the respirator at a whole nother level. How well does Booth know how to take off his respirator, adjust it, read-on that respirator to get a fit testing score here? Again, it's the only technology that can do this step, because with other technologies, you cannot remove the respirator during fit testing. So we get an initial donning at the beginning of the test, and two read-ons at the end. So Booth again will read-on the respirator once he makes sure that it feels well. This is also a great training step for employees and test subjects, because it gives Booth confidence that he can produce this fit over and over again with this respirator style each day of work. So it's very important. It's not just a fit test, it's also training for him as he's going through the process of fit testing. So again, if we pass the fifth step, he's done. So that's your full OSHA ISO respirator fit testing using the read-on protocol in just under 2 minutes. So let's transition to next steps.
We really enjoyed sharing the QuantiFit2 with you today. Hope it's been beneficial. We have a big desire to connect further with you. We'd love to provide an on-site or virtual demonstration of the QuantiFit, specifically discussing how it would interact with your respiratory protection program and meet your needs. So big desire to connect further and really help in any way that we can.
Yeah, and the best way to do that is to visit quantifit2.com. Reach out to us. You can set up that on-site demonstration, virtual demonstration. You can also get more information about the technology and about the protocols that we talked about today. Thank you for your time.